Good morning, everyone. You're watching Grace for Your Day. We are in the Gospel of John. We're in chapter 5, and this morning we're going to read verse 10. This is a really cool verse. The Jews therefore said to him who was cured. Now they're talking to the man that came from the pool of Bethesda. He's been healed now. The Jews therefore said to him who was cured, "It is the Sabbath. It is not lawful for you to carry your bed." You know, I believe that God is into celebration. I believe that we get our desire to cheer, to praise, to celebrate. I believe we get that from the Lord. The Bible says that there's a celebration in heaven every time someone comes to repentance. But it's important that we celebrate the right thing. The Pharisees of Jesus' day, they didn't celebrate the right thing. They celebrated their righteousness. They celebrated their law-keeping. They celebrated their traditions. And because of this, they missed an incredible opportunity to celebrate and to give God glory because of the miracle that Jesus had worked in his life. Now, this man was paralyzed for almost 40 years, and Jesus had healed him. I mean, think about that. But instead of giving the Lord praise, they found fault. They were more concerned about their interpretation of the law and how it was being kept. This man was obviously doing work on the Sabbath day by carrying his own bed. I mean, of course he was carrying his own bed. He didn't need that bed anymore. He was no longer paralyzed. You know, I see this happening more than I would like to admit. I see people that miss out on celebrating the things of God, celebrating God's grace, celebrating God's incredible acts of mercy, only because he didn't do it in a way that was comfortable to those people, only because there was a method that they were not pleased with or happy with. You know, I've got a news flash this morning. God isn't into making you comfortable with how he does things. God's just into doing things. I mean, if God is saving, if he's delivering, if he's doing mighty things through a ministry that uses methods that you don't like, that you don't prefer, that are not your favorite, well, what are you going to choose? Are you going to choose to celebrate your traditions? Or are you going to celebrate God's glory? Are you going to celebrate God's power? You know, I personally believe that as a body of Christ, we would not be so divided if we could just simply learn how to celebrate what God is doing in the world today. If we would make a conscious effort to celebrate, transform lives, however and wherever God may be transforming them. And I just want to see people saved. I want to see people changed. I want to see people healed and delivered. And if heaven is celebrating it, I want to be in on that celebration. I pray the word has encouraged you this morning. We'll see you again in the morning on Grace for Your Day. God bless.